Gauss theorem I will discuss in this particular video lecture. For such video lecture you can visit my blog at www.apnephysics.com. Myself Sushil Kumar. So first of all, as usual, as I discuss supporting physical concept before I start the topic, the three supporting physical concepts are included here. Number one is the electric flux, number two is the type of surfaces, whether that is closed surface or open surface, and at number three, that is the solid angle. So these are the three key points of this lecture which information one have to clear. So first of all, this electric flux, what is it means and how one can visualize to it. The electric flux basically is a measure of the number of line of forces passing through either closed or open surface in the electric field. So this you can consider is an electric field in which there is a closed surface, this highlighted area, and through it the electric field line of forces passes. So this number of line 1, 2, 3, 4, these four line is basically electric flux in a simple way. If we have to define it mathematically, then what we will do, we just consider an elementary area, and as you know that area is a scalar quantity, but in terms of the vector we have to consider the direction, that is the perpendicular to the plane of area, right? And that is denoted by this vector dA. E, this one is the direction of the electric field, and angle between these two is the theta. So scalar product E dot dA provide the electric flux which passes through this elementary area. If we have to find out the total electric flux, then we will integrate it, and because this is the closed surface, so we have considered here this closed surface integral E dot dA. So one can find out the total electric flux which is passing through this closed surface. Here second concept, as I told you that this is required, and many times its physical interpretations helpful to symbolize the integral notation like here. So if I'm using this closed surface integral, it means that the surface may be like this one, a square form, in a rectangular form, like this circular form, triangle form, and any shape that is basically closed, that is not open, you cannot go through this, right? Nothing physical object can pass through it. Open surface means like the ring, right? Like a ring, the space is open here, one physical object can pass through it. And similarly, this shape are different, but open surface means open surface may be of any type like closed surface. The difference is only that here in open surface the central part is basically is open, any physical object can pass through it. And the symbol for that is this is closed surface integral for such type of surfaces. Open surface integral we use such type of surfaces which is bounded by some circular, rectangular, or like these shapes. So this is the idea of closed surface. And now the idea of solid angle. Solid angle omega is the ratio of the part of a spherical surface area as subtended at the center of a sphere to the square of the radius of the sphere, where S is equal to total area and R square is the radial distance, this one. So omega is denoted by this one, this is the solid angle. If you consider this curved surface and this curved surface subtended an angle here, that is known as the solid angle, and by definition we write it 4 pi r square upon r square, where r square cancel out this r square, so you have only 4 pi, right? So by this way we define the solid angle. Now the point about the Gauss theorem. This theorem gives a relation between the electric flux, number one, through any closed surface, that is known as Gaussian surface, and the charge enclosed by the surface. The picture I will show in the next slide. So electric flux and charge relationship provide through the Gauss theorem. It states that the electric flux phi e through any closed surface is equal to 1 upon epsilon naught times the net charge that is enclosed by that closed surface. So here phi e is denoted by this closed surface e dot da, or sometimes book can write it ds, it does not matter. So this basically, this mathematical part is denoted by electric flux, and electric flux is what, as I told you, that is the information of line of forces which passes through a surface in the electric field, and this is equal to q upon epsilon 0, and q here is enclosed by the closed surface. So this is the formula, a statement of the Gauss theorem. If we have to draw this particular law, that is known as Gauss law in electrostatics, then we have to consider here a point charge plus q, and this plus q charge basically is enclosed into this random surface. A is the closed surface, A, this one is denoted by the surface, right? And dA, small area element surrounding a point P on the surface. Here you can see this P point, and this is the P point, a small area element, right? And this is the small area element, and the direction of it is this one, denoted by unit vector, and that is perpendicular to this plane, and in the same direction you can see this vector dA. Electric field line passing through it in this way and making an angle theta, as you have seen earlier, this one. So this is vector E, this is vector dA. OP is equal to R, this center point where we have kept this positive charge Q, and the distance between this P is R, this is R. dA, area vector normal to the area element. D omega is the solid angle element, as you have seen in the last slide. This is the elementary area which subtended an angle on this point O makes this d omega. D omega here is the solid angle made by this small elementary area, and theta, as I told you, angle between dA and unit vector n e. So let E of the electric field at P due to charge plus Q at O, its direction is along OP, the electric flux through the area element dA. Now it means that we have to find out the electric flux which basically passes through the elementary area. So what we will do, we will just take the differential part of that. So d phi E, electric flux, is equal to scalar product between E and dA. Theta is the angle, so the result will be EDA cos theta, where E and dA is magnitude of vector E and dA. Here E is the electric field. The formula for that is 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught into q upon r square. When we put the value of E in this formula, it becomes q upon 4 pi epsilon naught dA cos theta as it is, and this r square here. This dA cos theta upon r square is basically the solid angle d omega subtended by the area dA at the point O, right? So now we can write this differential flux through the elementary area is equal to q upon 4 pi epsilon naught into d omega. If suppose we have to find out the total electric flux throughout that closed surfaces in which that charge is kept, so we have to take the integration, and integration will be closed surface integral. So here I have to write closed surface integral. So this closed surface integral d omega will be equal to 4 pi. When we take the integration closed surface integral of it, right? So what will happen? This q upon 4 pi epsilon is constant, so comes out from this one, and d phi e represent in this way total phi e electric flux, right? And d omega here is the 4 pi. So when we write 4 pi here, 4 pi cancel out, and you have only q upon epsilon naught. So by this way one can prove the Gauss law in electrostatics. Now if suppose charge is outside the closed surface, then what will be the electric flux which passes through the closed surface? Now in this situation charge is outside and this is the closed surface. So suppose electric flux enter through this elementary area, that is dA1, and here direction is inward of the electric flux, or you can say the electric lines, and here the direction is outward through this elementary area, that is denoted by dA2, and it is denoted by unit vector n. So the point is total electric flux now through dA1, that is suppose phi 1, is equal to minus q upon 4 pi epsilon naught d omega, and this is inward right here, this electric field lines inwarding through it, you can represent, and here outward direction. So this negative sign basically is, this is the only important point when you write that positive charge is outside of the closed surface, why the total electric flux through the closed surface is zero. You have considered here negative sign because electric flux basically enters here at this point, and that signifies the negative sign, right? And here the electric flux at phi 2 is outward direction, that is positive. Why we consider here negative and positive sign? Because you know that if I consider positive sign, positive charge, the electric flux will be outward, and if I consider negative charge, then electric flux will be toward it. So there is an analogy basically with this result. It means here q basically indicating the negative charge when we are saying inward electric flux. So this is the point, and when you add this phi 1 and phi 2, total electric flux, that becomes zero. So this was the important point here, if you have to explain it logically. So the total flux through the two area is zero. Note, Gauss theorem is useful to find the electric fields due to a single or group of charges or continuous distribution of the charges. So for that purpose we use it. Thanks for watching this video. If it is helpful, please like and share and subscribe the channel. Thanks.